Angkor Wat is one of Asia's most impressive ancient sites. Millions flock to the ruins each year to admire the beautiful architecture and impressive temple, hoping to gain some insight into this culture that once thrived in the region. According to archaeologists, its build was over 800 years ago in honor of Hindu gods. Researchers and scholars have laid their eyes on the beauty of the Angkor Wat and have been thoroughly fascinated by its marvelous structures and the intricate layout of the site. However, very few people know of its intricate hydraulic water system, which appears to have been built using some form of ancient technology. Join us in this video as we embark on a journey back in time to the 12th century to investigate the legends of the demigod builders of the site and how they built such an intricate water system that some have suggested is as impressive as anything in modern times. The site of Angkor Wat. Located in the northwestern part of Cambodia, Angkor Wat is widely considered one of the most fascinating temple structures in the world. The site once stood as the capital of Khmer Empire, which presided over a vast portion of Southeast Asia. According to historians and archaeologists, the Khmer Empire rose to prominence in the 9th century, but rose to its greatest height around 1100 CE. During this period, a great king arose who would go on to build Angkor Wat with the help of 300,000 men and 6,000 elephants. The official story behind the construction of the elaborate temples and surrounding structures begins with King Suryavarman II, who ruled from 1113 to 1150. He ordered the construction of Angkor Wat and was built over several decades. It served to function as a temple complex, mausoleum, and political center for his vast empire. Created for the Hindu deity Vishnu, the Angkor Wat complex was built to represent the Hindu universe. Five sandstone towers rise above the temple enclosures. The central tower represents the mythical Mount Meru, the center of the Hindu universe, and the home of the god Brahma and the Devas, and the surrounding four smaller peaks. The temple wall and surfaces are covered with intricate carvings, designed to be viewed in an anti-clockwise direction. These depict deities and other figures from Hindu and Buddhist scriptures, telling the stories of the history and mythology of Cambodia. They even include scenes from the Hindu Mahabharata and a carving of Emperor Sarvavarman II entering the city for the first time. The unique complex water system. In architectural terms, Angkor Wat is often considered a masterpiece. The main temple is an enormous pyramid made up of three levels. It was built upon a piece of land that is surrounded on all sides by water. Most of the major structures are made from intricate blocks of laterite encased in sandstone, while the surrounding buildings would have been made from less durable materials such as wood. The Angkor Wat Temple is surrounded by an enormous moat measuring approximately 200 meters across. This again relates back to an idea that suggests it's supposed to represent the ocean surrounding Mount Meru. However, one of the most fascinating aspects of the city that's rarely talked about is its advanced hydraulic system. During the 1950s and 60s, French archaeologist Bernard-Philippe Groslier was working at the site and decided to reconstruct the layout of the land using aerial archaeology. He soon revealed to the world the complexity of the site's water management system, leading him to refer to Angkor Wat as the hydraulic city. Following in his footsteps, various researchers over the next 70 years would also investigate the unique water network and the vital role it played for the site's inhabitants. In 2012, the true extent of the hydraulic system was revealed when a group of researchers performed airborne laser scans at the site. It revealed that the water management system runs for over 1,000 square kilometers by way of unique man-made canals that are carved to steer water from the Phnom Kulen River to the plains of the ancient city. It's been surmised that the impressive canals allowed the ancient builders of Angkor Wat to transport millions of sandstone bricks, some of which weighed over a ton, to the site. The hydraulic water system was able to provide inhabitants of Angkor Wat with year-round water, which supported their population, livestock, and agriculture. But another impressive use of the water actually stabilized the foundations of the structure. The hydraulic system fed the foundations for a unique purpose. The builders realized that the sandy soil alone could not support the weight of the stones. So master engineers discovered that mixing sand and water creates stable foundations, so that the moats surrounding each temple were designed to provide a constant groundwater supply. This has created foundations strong enough to keep the temples stable and prevent them from crumbling all these centuries later. The hydraulic system was improved over the centuries by successive kings, who expanded and improved the complex water network. The system is made up of webs of canals, dikes, reservoirs, and moats, the largest of which is the West Beray, which is nearly 8 kilometers long, 2 kilometers wide, and is considered an engineering marvel. One archaeologist had the following to say about the hydraulic system. Angkor's hydraulic system is so unique because of its scale. Many examples of historic sites with elaborate water management systems exist, but nothing like this. The scale of the reservoirs, for example. The amount of water the West Beray holds is incredible. Many European cities could have comfortably sat within it when it was built. It's mind-boggling. It's the sea. The unique and complex architectural design and the impressive hydraulic system have led many alternative researchers to suggest that the site was built using some form of technology that was ahead of its time. While this may seem far-fetched, there are various legends from the air, both from the Hindus and later the Buddhists, that shed some light on the mysterious surrounding Angkor Wat, legends behind the construction. According to archaeologist Charles Higgum, Suryavarman wasn't just a man, but was a demigod. In all depictions of the fabled king, he appears large and muscular with his people seated around him. According to legends, he was of a divine lineage that stretched back into prehistory and was looked upon as a demigod by his people. Other legends portray him as an incarnation of Vishnu. However, scholars in recent years have refuted this idea and believe the legends that speak of his divine lineage are nothing more than propaganda created by the king himself to ensure no one challenges his rule. Yet we cannot deny the accomplishments during his short reign and his ability to extend the Khmer Empire. Could King Suryavarman have made a member of an ancient race that dates back to a time when the deities walked the earth according to Hindu tradition? Maybe he had imparted some of his knowledge to the builders during the construction of Angkor Wat. Well, it just happens that Buddhist traditions also speak of a unique legends surrounding this ancient city. Sometime around the beginning of the 13th century, Angkor became a Buddhist temple and became a refuge for the spiritual belief system. The Buddhists of the area recorded a unique legend passed on to them that the site of Angkor Wat was built in a single night under orders from the Hindu god Indra. The site of Angkor Wat certainly seems well beyond for numerous reasons, including its intricate hydraulic system and architectural planning. While the various legends surrounding King Suryavarman II and the Buddhist legends only further add to the mystery of the site, is there a possibility that it was built by the ancient Hindu gods? But what do you think? Have you ever been to the site of Angkor Wat for yourself? And do you think there's enough evidence to suggest that the hydraulic water system could have been knowledge passed on to the Khmer Empire from demigods? or with the ancient people living in the area of Cambodia, simply more advanced than the surrounding empires? Let us know all your thoughts in the comment section. If you enjoyed this video and would like to see more, hit the subscribe button and join us.